muscle cars, hot rods, and a whole lot of car shine. You'll find plenty of that here at the 17th annual Orange Plaza Car Show. The Sunrise Rotary are putting on a great show on this beautiful Southern California day. I'm Ruth Paul. Let's see what special cars Erin Lynn has picked out for us.
All right, it's 8:30 a.m. The sun is out, the birds are singing, and the bees are buzzing. I am here with Mark and Bumblebee, and this car is quite the transformer. Mark, can you tell me about Bumblebee?
Just a little bit. It's a 69 Camaro, of course, my favorite year in high school. I found this car in Tennessee and bought it over there, shipped it home, and it turns out that the car was built in Van Nuys, California, so I kind of brought it home. I like the 69 era, but I want modern amenities. I've got electric windows, locks, touchscreen stereo, nav system, tilt wheel, air conditioning, you know, all the luxuries there. And I did all the engine work myself. It's a World Products 427 small block, so it's a little bit different than a normal 350 small block. It puts out a lot of horsepower and torque, and put a lot of good parts in the motor because I tend to have a heavy foot and I want the engine to stay together for me.
All right, I'm inside Bumblebee right now, and Mark is going to tell me about his special exhaust. Can you tell me about that, Mark?
Yeah, so it's a custom 3-inch exhaust, and when it's all buttoned up and quiet, you know, that's the neighborhood version. But then you could press a button and open up the electric cutouts and go from quiet mode to what I call hot rod mode, and you can hear and feel all 600 horses. And I can give you a little demonstration if you like.
Let's do it.
Okay, so right now the exhaust is closed. And when we crank it up, it'll just rumble like a bumblebee. And then I'm going to open it up. And close them back. So when it's closed, it's nice and quiet. It just rumbles a little bit. But you can go from about 88 decibels to 105. Can't do too much of that all day because it'll wear out your ears.
That was awesome. Thank you so much, Mark.
I have a very special surprise for you car enthusiasts out there. One of a kind, and there's only one in the world. What am I talking about? You're about to find out soon. Come on. Big wheels, come on, turn it. That one? Mm-mm. Could it be that? No, still not. What I have for you is this. The Pantera. One of a kind, only one in the world. I'm here with Frank Spurney. Frank, could you tell us a little bit about this golden car?
It's a Pantera, a 1971 Pantera. It's been custom built for one of our customers. Every part of the car, with the exception of the hood, the transmission, and the taillights, have been modified. Now, this particular car was built to be shown at the Concorso Italiano about 5 years ago. It's an all-Italian sports car show up in Monterey, and the car won first place in its category. It has a custom-built engine for it. It has a paddle shifter built into it. The interior was completely custom-built. The Tom Charta is the one who designed the Pantera for De Tomaso, and then De Tomaso contracted with Ford Motor Company, and the Pantera was sold through the Lincoln Mercury dealers from 1971 to 1974. Our customer designed or had some ideas and spoke with Tom Charta. Tom Charta drew up the car, then gave us the plans, and then we custom built it according to his specifications. So like I say, it's a one-of-a-kind car because the Pantera was never designed originally to be a convertible, so we had to reinforce it to give it rigidity. And then, you know, we flared out the fenders, Ferrari headlights, custom wheels, and like I say, a paddle shifter, a very powerful, what's the engine power on this?
600?
About 600 horsepower, and that's pretty much it. Okay, do you have any other questions?
So what was, you're saying the Pantera wasn't built to be a convertible, so what did it normally look like?
Normally it's a fastback, it's a hardtop that's slanted back, very similar to this picture right here. This is also one of our cars that we custom built for our customers. We put flares on it, but that's what a Pantera looks like. Now, we're a local shop here in Orange, and we can custom build any car.
What are you called?
We're called PI Motorsports, and we've been in business since 1996.
How many times have you come to the car show? Is this your first time?
This is our 17th year that we've had two booths here.
All 17 years?
All 17 years.
We have a veteran right here.
We've been coming here.
So every year you've brought a Pantera?
Pardon?
Every year you've brought a Pantera?
Every year we've brought a Pantera, or at least one Pantera we've brought. Like I say, this is one of our very favorite cars. So like I say, we not only customize, we sell them, we also have parts, and then we work on custom building other cars as well that customers have for us.
Sweet home, Alabama, oh sweet home.
I'm just off the circle right now. I'm here with Dan. Dan, can you tell me about your car here?
Well, it's a 1955 Ford panel truck. Mostly they were used for electrical jobs, plumbing jobs, that sort of thing. And when I got it, I just kind of turned it into what I feel, you know, all of us enjoy without ever saying it, and that's Americana. So I put the flag on it, and everything inside and out is red, white, and blue.
That's amazing. And how long have you been coming to this car show?
Oh, about 5 years coming by every, when I can get here, you know. It's a lot of fun. You get to meet a lot of great people. You get to see a lot of different cars, get some more ideas for what you might want to do.
And what's so special about this one?
Well, I think this one, it gets to the heart of everyone. You may not know, you may not mention it out loud, but when you walk by, you take notice and it makes you think of things, especially about the guys out fighting for us in our country.
I'm here at the 17th Annual Orange Plaza Car Show with Mr. Larry Flores. How are you, Mr. Larry Flores?
Hello. Doing very well. Thank you.
Could you please tell us a little about your car?
Yeah, well, this is a 1923 Ford T-Bucket. It's a pretty fast car. It's a lot of engine. It's kind of like the reproduction from the car from the Munsters, kind of the same body style. And it's a fun car.
Can you tell us a little bit about the engine here? Because I understand that it's kind of out of the car almost. Is this normal for its class and its time period?
Yes it is. They used to have them out of it so you can see the engine. And there are a lot of cars like this, but this is kind of a unique one, but it's pretty fast. You know, it's you start it up and it revs up like a jet.
So how many times have you been in the car show?
And this is my first time in this car show here. I've been to a lot of them, but every time we come here, we miss the show. So we said, well, this time we're going to plan it, but it's more than 400 cars. It's outstanding.
Over in the corner weeping all alone. The warden said, hey buddy, don't you be no square. You can't find a partner.
All right, I'm here with surfer boy Gene Cole with his 1970 ragtop convertible. This might be one of my favorites just because I'm a surfer girl myself. Can you please tell me about this car, Gene?
I started building it about 6 years ago. It was a complete body-off restoration. And I wanted to make it look like a Southern California beach car. So what you see is the Southern California flavor.
Do you still take her out to the beach?
Oh, yeah. I go down to the beach once in a while, especially at the car shows. I don't drive it around that much, but once in a while, I'll cruise down by the beach on a nice sunny afternoon.
Catch some waves, too, with that board?
No, that board has never seen the water.
No?
Unfortunately, yeah. That's just for decoration, to add to the car.
And did you work on this car yourself?
I did a lot of work myself, but I had some really good people working behind me.
And is your favorite color red?
I do believe it is.
And is this your first year coming out to the show?
No, this is my fourth year here at the show. 4 years ago was the first time with this car, and I've been back every year since.
And you're a local here from Orange, correct?
Yeah, I live about a mile from here.
And what do you like about this car show in particular?
There's a variety of cars. You see everything that's in this car show. Some really nice cars, and the people are really nice.
You got me going now.
You have a beautiful Ford Thunderbird here. Can you tell us a little about it?
Yes, this is a 1957 Thunderbird. They made them 3 years, 55, 6, and 7. This is obviously the last year, and of course, I think the best year since I have it. But this particular car was owned by Burt Reynolds. I believe he had it for about 10 years. Then this car was in a museum in the in Florida for almost 20 years. And then I bought it at auction out of that museum when they closed it. And the car's been totally restored, body off restoration, and it's a work in progress. The car only has 61,000 actual miles on it today. But even though, but everything's been redone, motor, transmission, everything's all new, so.
So what type of work other than the motor have you done on it?
No, the motor's been totally rebuilt like brand new. Okay. From one end to the other, transmission, rear end, because it's, you know, it's 53 years old, nothing lasts forever, so. But it's a great driving car still to this day. It, no rattles, no shakes. It's a fun to drive car. I really enjoy it. My wife and I, you know, go out on Sundays and really enjoy this car. So no sense having it if you don't drive it. So.
Ladies and gentlemen, I am here with Chuck Taylor. Chuck Taylor, you are from Washington. Why are you here in Orange County? Obviously, this car show. Tell me about this car.
It's a very unique car. It's number 6 of, many years. It was made for, 4 or 5 years, I believe. But it's a 54, and these are very, this, I guess 54s are kind of hard to come by. It's number 6. And my dad bought it brand new, and he paid, I think, $8,000 for it. And it's been in the family, it's a one-owner car. It's been in the family for years. But this car is special to me because we've had in the family since day one. He had to Grasshopper. I remember it. But beautiful car, and I'm so glad I got to have it.
It's a beautiful car. And you told me that you didn't have any sort of nickname for it. You don't call her anything. If you could give it a nickname, what would you call it?
I guess Silverbird.
Silverbird?
Yeah.
With
the wings and everything.
Gliding through the streets.
I used to fly, and I flew myself. And it's like a bird with the wings. If it could fly, it probably would. I mean, longer wings. But I think I'd call it Silverbird. It's kind of a odd name, but not.
I think it's a great name. Love the car. Great weather. Thank you so much,
You're
Chuck Taylor.
Welcome.
Good luck today, and have so much fun.
Great. Thank you.
All right, I'm here with my friend Daryl with his 1926 Buick. Daryl, can you tell me about this car?
This car was bought in 1963 by my friend Ed Thomas. He bought it for $150. He spent 44 years restoring it before he got too sick to drive it, and he sold it to me about 4 years ago. He did all the work in his driveway in Villa Park.
And I know that this Buick has a special name. Can you tell us her nickname?
This is Marilyn, because it was made in 26, and Marilyn Monroe was born in 26.
And is there anything else that is special in particular about this Buick?
Only that it was a friend that restored it, and he is too sick to drive it, and it was special that he let me have it.
And is this your first year in this car show?
No, I've been here for 4 or 5 years. It's hard to get in. It's hard to get into the show. But we only live 2 blocks from here, so you can't pass it up.
What do you like about this car show?
It's close to home.
Close to home, you have your buddies, your wife, donut and milk.
Yep, and she won't eat the donuts. What are you going to do? Thank you very much.
Thank you so much for the interview, Daryl.
I'm here with Bob Whitaker and his 1960 Buick. Bob, could you tell us a little bit about your baby here?
I bought it in 2004. On a car lot in West Hollywood, and it was the paint color you see now, and the interior was already in it. And other than that, I changed the wheels and tires, put airbags on it to lower it down, and did, you know, keep re-chroming things and improving things like that. Cleaned the motor up just a little bit, but and then the idea primarily is to drive it and have fun with it.
Exactly. So do you have a nickname for this baby?
Well, its license plate says ain't pink, because when I brought it home, my buddies laughed at me and said, oh, you bought a pink car. And I said, no, man, it's not pink, it's coral. And so they always would, you know, kid me about my pink car. And so we decided to put the license plate on that said, you know, I said, it's not pink. And so we put ain't pink on there.
So far, how of this show compared to other shows?
This is a nice show. This is a real nice show. A lot of, you know, variety of cars and a perfect venue. I mean, it's and what a gorgeous day, huh?
Beautiful day.
Yeah. She says loving just for me. Oh, she loves me so tenderly.
All right, I'm here at the Cookie Lee Station with Karen and Stephanie. Ladies, can you please tell me what brings you out here today?
Well, besides the fact that it's a beautiful day, we're out here to sell this gorgeous jewelry, Cookie Lee jewelry. And my husband has a truck in the car show. And so it's really fun because I get to hang out with all the ladies selling the jewelry. And he shows his truck. And I met this beautiful lady at a meeting.
Yes, we did. Karen and I have been in Cookie Lee for about 9 years now. And been doing the show for about 4. Here at the Circle, and we just love it. We have a great time. We help all the women accessorize and shop for Mother's Day, graduations. Girls help with their prom jewelry, so it's just a lot of fun. We've selling our jewelry. We've booked a couple of shows so we can all get together with our girlfriends, and the hostesses can earn free jewelry. So we're having a good time today.
Yeah, so it's really fun. It's fun jewelry. We have something for everyone. We have everything from the very simple, elegant, to the really glitzy, glamoury, to the bohemian, to little girls. So there's just fun stuff for everybody.
And our items start at $4. The average price is about $24 to $32. We have a couple items that are watches that are in the $48 to $58 range.
Awesome, ladies. Can you maybe show me one of those staple pieces that you have?
Well, you know, we have a bunch of customers lining up back here.
I'll let you guys get back to that.
It's all right.
All right, we're nearing the end of the day, and I'm here with Jack, who is the president of Orange Sunrise Rotary Club. Can you tell me why it's Orange Sunrise Rotary Club?
Well, it started out on a sunrise club, and then we moved to a afternoon club, and so we have sunrise somewhere in this world every day. So we meet at 5:30 every Wednesday.
Awesome. And can you explain what trophies are going to be given away today, what awards we have, how many categories?
This is the Mike Sweeney Award, and Mike Sweeney is a man that started the car show 17 years ago, and Mike Sweeney passed away 5 or 6 years ago. So that's the Mike Sweeney Award. This is the best in show. That's the best car. Usually that car will probably sell for $150,000, $200,000. These are special awards. The Rotary Choice, Mayor's Choice, Police Choice, Fire Choice, Participant's Choice, you know. These are all special type awards. Then we have 26 categories where they've been judged by professional judges, and we'll be giving those to the best in each one of those categories.
Awesome, thanks so much, Jack. It seems like we're about to get started with announcing all the winners. I'm really excited. All right, and we'll toss it back to you.
We are here with Mr. Dave Ledford, who is one of the judges for the 17th annual Orange Plaza Car Show. So Dave, could you please tell us a little bit how you judge the cars?
Well, we judge the cars in 3 categories. First one is exterior, the second one is interior, and then the engine compartment. And it's a point scale, and a point scale of 1 to 10, and 1 being, you know, poor, 10 being excellent. And just go over and just give us our overall opinion of what we think of the vehicle is, you know, the condition of it. And some of us are partial to a certain kind of trucks and vehicles, and I chose to judge this class. And so far, we've got a really nice looking group of cars here for this year.
Jack and take that California trip. Get your kicks on Route 66. Get your kicks on Route 66. Thank you.
here with Pete Hoffman. The day is coming to an end. The cars are pulling out, and I'm with the man himself who just won Best in Show. Pete, can you tell me, did you expect this win at all?
No, not with 400 cars. I would feel real privileged.
And how many years have you been attending this car show in particular?
This is the first time I've ever been to this one.
Yeah. Congratulations, sir. That is an honor. Can you tell me about your car specifically?
Well, it's just a 1949 Cadillac that I did a frame-off restoration on it, and it took me over 2 years and lots of money. But I enjoyed it. That's what I love to do. So, and I did the upholstery because I am an upholsterer. So I don't know what else to tell you about it. It's all original, pretty much, you know, and I'm very proud of it.
Awesome. Thank you so much and congratulations. Enjoy the rest of your day and hopefully we'll see you again.
We like our phone and we never fight. You can't dance and stay uptight. It's supernatural delight. Everybody was dancing.
Another successful year here at the Orange Plaza Car Show.
With over 400 contestants and cars, around 30 people walked away with prizes.
But everyone got to showcase what they truly love.
We'll see you next year. I'm Ruth Paul.
And I'm Aaron Lim.
They don't bark and they don't bite. They keep things loose. They keep